historical multicultural pods in British metropolis. And while I do this, I've been listening very carefully to the expressions people used, so sometimes I might stop the interviewers or the tour of London and repeat what the person said so that you can focus on the language. Well, this is a conversation. absolutely wonderful. Well, all the producers here are very small producers, and no of them invest any money in advertising at all. So when they're in competition with the really well-known names like Rick Wakeford or Bernison, I mean, it's very difficult for them to have a presence on the market. But they produced obviously by hand, using unpasteurized milk, a lot of these, so they're just a good quality. Excellent. I would love a piece of Stitch Chilton, actually. A piece of Stitch Chilton, sure, yeah. How much do you need? That's fine, thanks. That's 4 and 45, thank you. Can I just ask how often do you the testings? The testings are once a month. And have you got a website? We do, yes. It's nirsayaratari, all in one word, .com.uk. Lovely, thanks very much, thanks. Let's change the theme. Here's another conversation, English conversation. Wordplay, episode 1. Rachel and John, Michelle, Sally, Derek, Rachel. Rachel. Hello and welcome to the Wordplay, the quiz, panel game, and chat show all rolled into one. With me in the studio are our teams, John and Michelle on my right. Hello, John. Hello, Michelle. Hi there. Rachel, and on my left, Sally and Derek. Sally, hello everyone. Derek, good evening. Rachel, before we start, just a quick word in your ear. Rachel, now let's begin our quiz with a few multiple choices questions. I'll start with an easy one. And it's for John Rice. Malt and balsamic are all gates of wine, cinder, vinegar, or oil. John, yes, well, that is easy. That is easy. There are all kinds of vinegar, apple rice vinegar on Chinese food, balsamic vinegar in my salad dressing, and malt vinegar on my fish and chips. Sounds good, that's 1 point for your team. Rachel, Michelle, well done, John. Rachel, now, Sally, here's yours. Chutney, basmati, and samosa are food-related names from which language? Hindi, Arabic, Greek, or Thai? Sally, well, we do eat quite a lot of Indian food in Australia. So as it happens, I know the answer. They're all Hindi words. Rachel, and can you tell us what they mean? Sally, well, chutney is a kind of spicy jam that goes so well with curries. It's often made from mangoes. Personally, I love that combination of sweet and spicy food. Rachel, yes, I know what you mean, Sally, and thanks for the graphic description. A point for your team, and let's move on to the Michelle. Michelle, it's your turn now. Michelle, ready when you are. Rachel, okay. America's favorite pizza topping is tuna, mushrooms, or pepperoni sauce, cheese. Derek, well, my favorite is Hawaiian pizza, you know, ham and pineapple. John, you'd never find one of those in Italy. Michelle, no, I'm sure you wouldn't. Rachel, what's your answer, Michelle? Michelle, well, I lived in America for 4 years and I'd have to say pepperoni. Rachel, and you'd be absolutely right, well done. In Pakistan, by the way, they like curry on their pizza. congratulations. I've no idea. I had to take a guess and say spaghetti. Rachel, no, sorry, spaghetti actually comes from the Italian for small strings. The correct answer is lasagna, from the Roman word lasagna, which meant cooking pot. By the way, that small thin pasta you can put in soups, you know, the one called vermicelli, well, that means little worms. I think some of the names are lovely though. Conchiglie are shells, because that's what they look like, and it's the same for cavatappi or corkscrews. And orecchiette, little ears. Then there's fettuccine, which means little ribbons, and linguine, little tongues. Oh, I'd better stop. As you can see, I love all kinds of pastas. Derek, fascinating. I eat pasta all the time, but I never thought about what their name means. What their names mean. Rachel, glad you enjoyed it, Derek, but I'm afraid of you. For you, still have no points for your answer. So at the end of round one, the scores are John and Michelle 2 points, and Sally and Derek 1. I've finished.